Hi everybody, and welcome to the fourth and final edition of the Moha Save Our Skin campaign. It's been an amazing three editions of this series, and I've really had some great conversations with Sejal Jain at Glam Protocol. And you know, this time we've decided to choose a topic on care of the hands, nails and feet. Now, this is a topic which is rather unusual, and we thought we should cover it because it's an unusual topic, not often covered, not often spoken about, and really if you look around, you hardly find any information on it. And so we thought that let's cover this and let's share. There are so many things that we can talk about, care of the hands, nails and feet, right, starting from winter, which is right now, as well as to care in general, right through the year, every day. Hi, Sonali, good to see you again. And right through winter, right through the year, what you can do at home, DIY, in general, or what you should look out for if your nails or hands or feet are not looking so good. When should you consult a dermatologist? When can you manage on your own? So there's so many interesting aspects that I'm going to cover with. So just waiting for her to get into the show and this Insta Live. So I must, till then, here comes Sejal Jain. And I must say that I would like to really thank. I must say that I would like to really thank the Moha team. They have given us a form in which we've been able to share. Both me, Dr. Manisha Mishra and Tara Sharma, all of us have had a great time. Hey!
Hello!
Oh, there was your Mehndi.
Yeah, I'm attending a Mehndi function of a cousin, so yeah. Hi, how are you?
Share, both me, Dr. Manisha Mishra and Tara Sharma, all of us have had a great time. Hey!
Hello.
Oh, there was your Mehndi.
Yeah, I'm attending a Mehndi function of a cousin, so yeah. Hi, how are you?
I'm good. Good to see you again, the fourth Friday in a row.
Yes, same here. I'm so happy to see you.
Yeah, actually, same here as always. And I was just saying that I really want to thank the Moha Save Our Skin campaign. This has been a great platform to share so many things about hair concerns, pigmentation, acne, and now about, something very unusual, isn't it?
There you go.
Yeah. Just before the show, I also went and got my nails nicely cleaned and kept them. So I can feel the part, right? I always believe you should feel the part. I feel that if you're talking about something, or whenever I come to the clinic, I always like to feel the part, because then I know I can give my best and I can feel good.
Yes, that's so true. Like always, or even with me, it happens when there are certain things like that. I make sure that we are also following it, and it is a constant reminder as well.
It is, so, isn't it?
Yes, totally.
In my rule book, there is no room for shabbiness. You gotta look good all the time. But
yes,
in a nice way.
Yeah, agree. So let's begin. Let me just introduce what we are doing over here to the audience who joined in. Okay. So guys, Moha Save Our Skin, or SOS, is a series of live Instagram sessions with eminent experts from the field of dermatology, cosmetology, and yoga. This whole series is initiated by the country's Ayurveda expert, Tarak Pharma. The sessions are conducted every Friday and Saturday at 4:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 p.m. a.m. And today's topic is all about nails, hand and feet concerns. And we are going to nail this topic with the help of none other than Bollywood's favorite, my favorite, Dr. Mallika. who has rich practice of 20 years in the field of dermatology and cosmetology. So once again, hello, doctor.
Hi, it's actually 27 years.
27, oh, wow.
7 years, yeah. Super. It's been a great journey. It's been a great journey. I've learned a lot. Thank you.
So yes, so let's begin. I'm super excited.
Me too.
Great. So first question would be my actual question, which I also very much wonder, why do body lotions, what we have in general, don't work on our feet in the same manner? Do they lack something? There is something which is missing? Would you like to throw something on that? Can we start with this?
Yeah, I think that's a very, very good, very good question. And because you are actually asking me to highlight the difference between the skin of the hands and the feet, between the body and the hands and the feet, there's a difference in the skin. So while the top of the skin of the hands and the feet, what we call the dorsum of the hands and the feet, is a little thinner, it's also more prone to dryness because it's more prone to wear and tear, washing, sanitizing now, as well as, you know, we do everything with our hands and feet. When you walk, when you run, when you work out, when you exercise, your feet are under so much wear and tear. And also the palms and the soles, the skin is different. It has an extra layer called the stratum lucidum. And this is what makes the palms and soles thick. But you need thick palms and soles to be able to do all the work that you want to do. You can, you know, it helps, gives you the grip, it gives you the strength in your hands. So that is why you need a different set of products to work on hands and feet, palms and soles. The nails have a thicker layer of keratin. And it's that thick layer of keratin that makes the nail hard. That's what makes the nail plate hard. And that is why you need to have products that will work on the nail and penetrate the nail plate. And the nail fold and cuticle also is different from any other part of the body. So the very specific area. So you're absolutely right in bringing out the point that this is a specific area, so it has specialized needs and therefore special care products.
Awesome, awesome. While you were saying, you also mentioned that nails are made up of keratin, something, you know, whatever we mentioned about. So do we need to follow some specific diet as well when we are trying to take care of our nails or hands or feet for that?
For the hands and the feet, the diet is more or less the same. You know, you need to have good D3, your B12, your iron, your vitamins, your protein, everything. But for your nails, you need to make sure you have enough biotin, specifically biotin, and everybody knows that, calcium. Yeah. And you also need to have, your omega-3s. And you also need to have good iron. You know, if you have low iron, your nails can become what we call spoon-shaped. If you have kidney or liver disease, you can actually have changes on the nails which can suggest kidney or liver disease. So you need to have a healthy body to have the best kind of nails. There's also something called clubbing of the nails. They become like this. And clubbing of the nails can indicate a lung problem. So, yeah. So, if you have a good set of antioxidants, enough protein, calcium, biotin, and you take care of your nails, you know, you're going to groom your nails. So, I'm sure you're going to ask me about that. But this is basically, yes, you're right. The nails are a barometer to internal health, just as the hair is.
That's true.
And of course, nowadays, you know, there's a lot of us are doing gel nails, artificial nails, you know, nail art. So we air our nails out. Yeah. So you know what these gel nails and artificial nails do? They really take off the first layer of the keratin because you've got to chip it off, right? When it wears off, you've got to scrape it off, and that takes off the first layer of your keratin and thins out your nails. And because you don't let them breathe, you tend to get fungal infections of the nail. And that is why you need to moisturize, hydrate, give gaps between all these cosmetic treatments. So like you've gone for a wedding and, you know, you'd love to do some nail art and do some glitter and something that lasts some months because then you don't want to redo your nails. And so at least that way in lockdown, everybody sort of gave a break.
That's true. That's true. I myself, since we come to extensions part, I love doing extensions. I'm like crazy for nail extensions and beautifying the thing. But obviously, as a doctor and otherwise also, I know for sure because when they are scraping it off, you know that your nails are going thinner. So that is in the back of my mind that I need to give a break always, you know, between my extensions. This whole 10 months extension that we got, and I was actually contemplating whether should I get back to doing nail extensions or not. Are they actually not good for your nails? I mean, they are harmful, or giving break is good enough? And I would want to know that because my nails do chip. So I know there is calcium and all playing in that. But you tell me, what about extensions? Are they okay to be done, or you should avoid them completely, or do it very minimal?
So, you know, if I say don't do them, nobody's going to listen to me. We're all going to do the nail gel nails. But I must tell you that I've never done it to my nails, ever. I've never, ever done it. But that's not the point. The point is that, yes, we all are going to get tempted to get our gel nails, or these are gel nails or some nail extensions. So, you know, you're going to have to do them because you want to have groomed nails and you travel when you work. So, give a gap. Like, you go back to get them cleaned up and remove the previous one. At least give a little breathing gap, maybe for 2 weeks for the nails to recover. Mm-hmm. And that much time you can get to hydrate them with a good nail cream, which has flaxseed oil, almond oil, you know, and that will help to lubricate the nails. You get these cuticle creams so the cuticles can recover. And then after that, you can then go back and do the next session. So give a little break. I would suggest that. And don't use acetone to remove nail polish. It's very hard on the nails because acetone is very dehydrating. And don't over trim your nails, over buff. You know what happens when your nails get a little dry? You tend to over buff them. And when you over buff them, they get very thin. And then you put the next layer of polish and you put again acetone. So these are the things, or the glue. So these are the things that you have to then give a little gap. So your nails can recover and you can nourish them with good creams. Even glycolic, urea, lactic acid creams can help to exfoliate, can help to hydrate. And then, you know, the natural oils like almond, flaxseed, so many things like that can help to restore the hydration. Even ceramides, even evening primrose oil, all these oils are very good.
Awesome. So what I pick up from that, if I'm actually causing not damage, but if I'm trying to experiment with something as a part of it, you have to take extra care of it, nourish it more, so that the problems. That's what I think. That is what really required.
Yeah. Let your nails breathe.
As well. So, like you mentioned, almond oil and flaxseed oil. So, I actually started using Moha foot care cream and the nail cream they have. So, my manicure pedicure sessions have gone for a toss. First of all, clinic, shoots, and now wedding. So I was extremely hyperly busy. So frankly, that was the only thing. And applying a little bit of olive oil. So they, you know, these are the combination of things I was doing, and they're working well. I mean, I'm happy. I'm not like, you know, oh no, my hands are not looking good or presentable for a wedding. They are
fine. Yeah, good. That. Because you're taking care. So the first thing is that in the winters, every night after you finish doing your face, you put your neck cream, then take your hand cream, and then use a good, you know, foot cream, or you can use a hand and foot cream. And then, you know, once in a while, you can add on the nail cream, or after your bath in the morning, because your nails are soft after a bath, you can put a little bit of the nail cream right after your bath. And I always tell my patients to rub it in a bit, you know, like how in a manicure pedicure, they rub it in a bit like that into the nail fold. So that makes the nails soft and nice, and, you know, so that really helps. So yeah, in winter, you need to definitely do this every night, but in summers, you can do it 3-4 times a week.
All right. That makes much sense. And quite frequent nowadays. That is what I agree to completely. Because it's dry, and you know, there is someone even asking, my nails break a lot. Can you please tell the reason for it? So actually, when I face the same problem, they kind of chip quite often, you know, and in winters even more. So any correlation, and how do we deal with it?
So one of the reasons nails chip a little more is if you know you're doing a lot of work with your hands, like after workouts, strong workouts, or you homemakers who are opening boxes and overwashing of hands with stronger detergents, or just frequent washing. And you know how we don't wash, we rub. So rubbing your nails, or if you are biting your nails, or you know, if in a, when you try to file them, you over file them. You try to do this, you know, they file at an angle. They start filing at an angle. They don't file like this. They start doing this action, over buffing. So you're thinning out the nail. So then it can chip. It can also chip if you use a lot of strong detergents, because it makes, it's called onychosia. And the nail separates. You know how it separates and then it chips?
Yes, I have one of them like that. So even the sanitizers and sterilum, which we are using very often now, can also cause it, because that also something I felt.
Because they're alcohol-based. And alcohol is dehydrating. That's why.
Yeah. That's true. So how do we tackle it? Like the same way we mentioned, like a lot of oils, what you mentioned, and something else?
Glycolic acid, urea, lactic acid. So you'll have to, you know, first of all, you have to understand what's caused it. So if you do a lot of housework, or some people, you know what, they love doing their own cleaning. They love to clean their own clothes, you know, their special garments. They like to clean their own crystal and artifacts. Or some people just love cleaning the house, you know. So then when you're overusing your hands and nails, then you should also, after, immediately after you're done with the job, either you wear gloves or immediately after the job, start nourishing and hydrating right away.
Okay.
So that you don't wait for the night, because by then you get very dehydrated. So if your nails are chipping, then you should use products that build up the nail. Build up the keratin, build up the nail. So that's why you can use ceramides and, you know, evening primrose oil and the oils. If your nails are actually, you know, getting damaged, like dystrophic, what we call damaged, discolored, thick over there, maybe there's a fungal infection. So you should look at taking either an antifungal tablet or using an antifungal lotion. But for that, you first need to confirm this with a dermatologist. Dermatologist who can confirm. But you know, nails also have conditions like psoriasis can affect the nails. So you know, you can get pits on the nails. So certain conditions can also affect the nails, which make the nails diseased. And so then you need to treat them medically. So there are medical creams which you may need to treat along with moisturizers.
Okay.
So a very common moisturizer has got urea and liquid paraffin. Simple one is urea, liquid paraffin. Some people dip their nails in liquid paraffin, castor oil, olive oil. You know, if you have that kind of time, it's great. But if you don't, you can use a good product. But you have to be regular. And one more advice I give my patients who have problems with their nails is try and use liquid detergents, not the powder ones. Because liquid, and when you want to clean or wash, use a brush. Don't put it on your hand and start cleaning. If you're washing your own, you know, special clothing or garments, then use liquid detergent, and dip it, and wear gloves. You know, those hardware rubber gloves are very nice.
Great.
These would be.
That would be really helpful, for sure. There is another question. My hands are very cold. Generally in winter, and body is warm. Is that okay? That's okay, I think,
You know, some people have sweaty palms. Some people have colder hands. It's, you know, because you know, being a doctor, that there is the parasympathetic and the sympathetic nerve system, right? So these are the nerves that come out of your spinal cord at the back. So some of us have variations in the behavior of the parasympathetic and sympathetic. So some people who sweat a lot and who or feel very hot all the time, the body tries to compensate by keeping the palms cool. Or those nerves are doing something else and these nerves are doing something else.
Yeah.
So it's sometimes, compensatory. Sometimes it's just the way you are. Sometimes your palms sweat a little extra because you just get nervous, you get emotional. Even certain foods, you know, like why do we get fungal infections? Because if we don't take care of our footwear, we don't air them out, we don't wash them regularly, if we don't take care of our, you know, feet, then they get moist. Like when you come out of the shower, I must tell you, One tip to prevent fungal infection of the feet is that when you come out of the shower, a lot of people just wipe it upar upar se and they're done, right? So what I recommend is come out of the shower, wipe your feet properly, and if you're prone to getting a fungal infection in the toes, you know, between the toes, then I usually tell them to take a hair dryer. And with a hair dryer, dry it up.
All right, that
So
is
all the
quicker.
water quicker. Quicker, yeah, good idea. And you can put a little thin piece of cotton and then wear your shoes. For those who wear their shoes all day, this works well.
Awesome. That's a beautiful tip for a lot of people who bet a lot
Yeah,
as well.
somebody was asking. Thank you. Somebody was asking about, thank you, Manisha, for appreciating the tip. And somebody was asking that, you know, why do their nails get discolored after removing nail polish? They find that their nails are yellow in color. So the answer is that some, you know, nail polishes which are red, maroon, deep colors, they use a very deep pigment. And if the quality isn't very good, yeah, then the pigment gets absorbed into the nail plate. You don't realize it till you remove it. Then you see that the nail is yellow. So that means that shade was very intense, the pigment was very intense, the quality may not have been too good, and therefore always put a base coat and then apply your nail polish. That's the reason of the base coat. And you can have base coats which are hardeners, so they harden the nail a little bit, so the nail becomes stronger, and then you put the nail polish. And that's another tip, you know, you get special nail hardeners. So for people like you were saying, no, they chip easily and they break, you can put nail hardener regularly, and that will fortify, that will strengthen your nails.
Great. I'll do that.
Yeah.
I have it, but it's
Yes.
just lying down. I'm gonna start using that,
Yeah, I think when you remove this nail polish that you've put on for the wedding and you're ready to remove it, so you know what you should do? Take your nail polish remover with a cotton pad. Make sure that it's a gentle. Now you get these nice nail polish removers which are like micellar waters, you know, they're a little oil based. And then after you remove it, always wash your hands. Take off the nail polish remover by washing your hands gently and immediately keep the nail hardener next to you and apply it.
Oh, nice. I mean, beauty tips, and these are going to be like really, really useful for sure. I think that also answers Sanai's question of how to fix nails that are brown color due to what nail polish leaves behind for many days. That's it.
I
There
saw a
were
couple of questions on cracked heels, right?
winters are getting on nerves. I think it's like started. I don't know, I'm not in Mumbai. How is it? It's raining quite a bit over here in my native, but Mumbai
Yes.
is, I've heard, and it's getting chilly now.
Yeah, when I got up at 6:30 in the morning, it was drizzling. And then luckily it stopped. I went for a walk. It was absolutely cloudy. Very unusual weather for December. Rainy and cloudy. Like, you know, when you're sometimes in Europe in December, it becomes very rainy and cloudy and cold. So it was a little like that, a little sort of coldish. But it was nice. It was different.
I think we
Now it's
can't travel
starting to rain.
abroad, so that's how the nature is playing with us and giving us the feel. Just
Giving
be
us another
positive.
wheel altogether. Yeah.
So yeah, what about cracked heels? Let's tackle that. Yes, tell us, please.
Yeah. So you know, on a day like today, I would say that the weather is the air is cool, but it is very humid today. It's a very unusual kind of weather. So you know, you should. So you'll feel, you know, as if when I put a nail, a foot or a hand cream, my hands or feet are going to feel very sticky. So the thing is that what you need to do is you need to use a lighter product. So you don't stop, like tonight, I am going to moisturize my hands or feet and feet, but I'm going to use a lighter product, not a sticky heavy product. Okay?
All
So that's one tip for, you know, when there are weather fluctuations. But coming to cracked heels, you know, cracked heels are very interesting. There's a history with that also. So there is a condition, Sejal, called plantar keratoderma. So plantar keratoderma means it's hereditary, that after the age of 30, you're going to end up having, like your mother has it, so you will also after the age of 30 have cracked heels. Okay? And you can do anything. They always get, it's hereditary. It's going to happen to you. It'll get terrible in winter, but it always will have those dry heels. And whatever you do, you go to the pedicure, you do it yourself, whatever, DIY, it never seems to improve. So this is a situation where you need deep hydration and where urea works, where salicylic acid may work because you get really thick soles. And in the cracks, when they hurt, you can put a little bit of antibiotic cream and a tape so that the crack quickly heals up, you know, like an antibiotic cream with vipiracin or fusidic acid. So after you moisturize your feet with a urea, liquid paraffin, soft liquid paraffin, cream or based cream, you put in the cracks, vipiracin or fusidic acid, tape it up. And before you do all this, you can soak your feet with a little bit of olive oil in it or a little bit of almond oil in it. But you know, now who's going to do all this? There's no time, right? And we're all looking for quick fixes with instant gratification, isn't it?
Yeah, totally.
So, so what I find really useful are these gloves for the hands. You get these gloves which have a cream inside it. And you get socks. So they're called like, they got collagen creams if you have aging hands. They have hydrating creams. So all you have to do is, you get them online, you know. A lot of companies have them online. So you just pick up any good brand and take the gloves. Just first nicely wash your hands and finish your filing of your nails and all. Open the glove, put your hand inside and massage massage your hand in that with a glove. Massage the glove because the cream inside will massage it into your nails and all. And then tape it up and sit for 20 minutes.
Oh, nice.
So you can even, yeah, so you can even clean, wash your, yeah, nice, no? So wash your hands, then you can even soak it in a little bit of water with a little almond or coconut or olive oil. Say, usually almond and olive oil for about 5-10 minutes. Soak it, then take them out, pat it dry. You can exfoliate if you want to with a hand and foot exfoliator. Then wear the gloves, okay, for your hands, the socks for your feet. Sit down for 20 minutes. Have a cup of coffee, green tea, read a book. And then after 20 minutes, take them off and just massage that cream. And that's a great way. You can do that in winter more often. On a yearly basis, you can do it once every week as a treat to your hands and feet. And but if you have specifically cracked heels, then you'll have to use some urea, salicylic acid, like.
Yeah, if it is like very often
and the antibiotic cream.
Yeah. Then you should also consult the dermatologist,
yeah.
I guess.
And another condition, yeah, then you have to see a dermatologist. If you're not improving, then see a dermatologist because there's also another condition called psoriasis which can affect the feet.
Yeah. That's true. Am I audible?
I think we're having some network. Was there some network issue?
Yeah, I can't hear you out here. I think there was some disturbance. Yeah. All right. So
I can hear you.
Yeah. No, it's fine. Yeah. So talking about taking care and how often you should do all this thing and groom your and take care of cracked heels. Also, like we all do manicure, pedicure. So, and now it is obviously there is a lot of gap because of you don't want to go to salon, you don't want to, you know, you try to do it yourself, even DIYs and using these creams that I mentioned also works. So, but how often one should go to dermat, salon for, you know, manicure, pedicure?
Sure. So, you should do a manicure not earlier than once a month. And a pedicure could be once a month, even once in 6 weeks. Now, why? Actually, you know, maybe people don't know this, but your fingernails take 6 months to grow fully. Like one full nail will take 6 months to grow. And on your toenails, it takes a year. your turnover of skin on the hands and feet is every 28 days.
Acha.
So if you're going to constantly go more often, you're not achieving anything. You're actually removing you're over removing the skin, and that gives a feedback to the skin to try and save it, and then it'll get or you'll thin out the skin, and then you can get a problem, right? So that is why it's very important that you do manicures once in a month, pedicures once in a month, because your turnover is like that. So you're going to finish a cycle of turnover, and then you're going to get rid of that layer, freshen up that skin and get a new nice layer. Then you wait for 28 days for the next cycle. You don't overdo it for the nails because they grow really slowly. So just by constantly over-treating them, the good nail will also get bad. The good skin will get removed. You want good skin and good nail. You don't want good nail and good skin to go.
Right.
You want to hold on to all the good things.
Yes.
So that's why you need to go that not too frequently. Another thing is about cuticles, you know?
Yeah.
So the cuticle care is very important. So, you know, a lot of people go on. Oh, thanks for agreeing with us. Some of you are there enjoying our chat. The cuticle out here, you should not even, sometimes a pedicurist can over, you know, try to clean your cuticle. And then if you clean the cuticle too much, then also you will open the cuticle, and then disease can enter. And that's not a good thing either. Disease will enter. And then you can get a fungal, or you can get a swelling called paronychia or swelling. And that is not good.
Yeah, because sometimes those are not very
good.
Even in the salon, try to do that. And even, many people have this habit of making it extremely round. So they are actually damaging the sides, which is very important. Right?
Very important point. Yeah. They cut it too deep, right? They cut it too deep.
Because
especially
I have
for
foot also being very bad with this problem. Yeah.
You're absolutely right. Because, you know, this is especially true when you are doing a pedicure and, you know, you're reading a magazine and the guy's trimming and trying to clean out. You know, they say, oh, some andar ka, I'm removing all the dirt and all that. Actually, they're cutting too deep. That is the first thing that will lead to an ingrown toenail. So you don't want to have an ingrown toenail by cutting the sides, the two edges too deep.
Yeah.
So that's important, yeah. So about the feet and the hands, another thing which is very important is that, you know, we should choose our hand washes, we should choose our shampoos, we should choose our body washes carefully. Because even when we do anything at home, like there are a lot of homemakers who joined us and have to do their stuff, and they should be careful about not buying very harsh based detergents. You see a lot of allergies to detergents. They can lead to a hand eczema.
Yeah, it's
you can
very
also
important.
Get a hand eczema with
Because people try to find a solution for the problem, but actually you're not addressing the cause, which is this harsh products and detergents. Yeah.
Exactly. You're a doctor, you know.
Exactly. Feet and hands are so neglected. Like in the clinic also, so many people walk in once they have a problem. Like they reach to a stage where pain is there with corns and callus. Bro, you don't have to get them so deeper so that you get to, you know, bear the pain. Now in the first stage, or try treating them in the first. That itself will cause. So yeah, in India, I don't think so. Abroad, it's a problem, because I know for sure I have patients who come, like, you know, they are like more of prevention types. But here we are neglecting. I have been telling you, when we are neglecting, we need to pay more attention to wearing tight footwear as well, and protecting our products and using the right products. Yeah.
Actually, there was a question earlier from somebody that they have these yellow hard areas on their feet. It went a little earlier in the question, and they were asking that, what can I do for the yellow hard areas on my feet? Yeah, calluses. Yeah, you know that. Well, somebody asked just now, is a manicure pedicure mandatory? No. You can look after your hands and feet very well at home. But the only reason people go for manicures and pedicures is because they don't want to do it at home. And they get to relax. And they want a little professional care. So if you're going to do a manicure pedicure at home, great. If you go to do it outside, go to a place where the instruments are well sterilized, where the towels are clean, where they take good care in, you know, doing a good, gentle job. A lot of people go and get these very vigorous manicures and pedicures and end up with nail abscesses and nail infections. So yes, you have to choose the right place, and it should be hygienic with all hygienic tools and equipment. But yeah, coming back to these callosities, you know, these callosities. So we, you know, on a foot, you can get warts, callosities and corns. So really what we want to talk about is your footwear, isn't it? Now, because you, this is your specialty, you tell us a little bit about the importance of footwear.
So basically, wearing a right type, like we all like heels. Heels are good, but make sure you're not putting so much of pressure on your forefoot all the time. Like, you can obviously have it on and off, because weight, wearing wrong footwear, not using right product is going to make your skin hard, and then start, you know, that yellowish discoloration, which we call as calluses, and then it goes deeper and deeper, sometimes get infected, sometimes there is thorn, which goes deeper and deeper. So yeah, that's very important, like what you mentioned, footwear, correct type of, where it is not so much of pressure on forefoot. But apart from that, if you have certain problems like flat foot or any alignment issue, what we talk about, then of course you have to see a podiatrist, or at least wear something which is going to make you more evenize the pressures around you. Otherwise, that will bring out more problems again. So then we work in joint.
Yeah,
before we offload the pressure.
Yeah.
Before reaching that stage, you should actually address the problem and, you know, not get to that stage. I would personally say that.
Yeah. So, you know, corns are painful. So whenever you start getting something painful on the sole of your foot, you know that you could be starting with a corn. How do you know it's a corn? Because when you press it down like this, I mean, I'm showing my hand, but I can't show my feet, but you know what I mean. If this is my sole of my foot, if I press it down and it hurts, it's a corn. If I pinch it, it's a wart, but a viral wart. And a callosity is just thick, hard skin. So if you have a lot of callosities, it could be because you're a runner, you're playing squash or badminton or tennis. It could be because you just haven't taken care of your feet. And callosities come from, you know, when you don't wear, put right pressure in your footwear, or your footwear doesn't match your foot.
Right.
Corns means you're putting abnormal pressure. There's something you're doing with your feet and footwear which don't match each other.
Yes.
And wart means you've picked up a viral infection from soil or a beach or walking barefoot, or, you know, when you see people who swim because their feet get, So we can treat all of them. But it's very important that you also take care of your footwear, keep them clean. Like I tell all my patients that, you know, when you finish wearing, say, your shoes for the day, first keep them out for at least 1 or 2 hours, 2, 3 hours, so that they air out. If you're prone to fungal infections, athlete's foot, then put a nice dusting powder which has clotrimazole, starch, you know, antibacterial chlorhexidine combination, and air it out. Then put it away in a closet or a cupboard or your shoebox. And then I tell them, wash your feet, dry them, use a hair dryer if you're prone to fungal infections, dry out the water. And then I tell them to, use an antifungal cream or a good exfoliating cream. So these are the various ways in which you can prevent a fungal infection from getting a grip on your feet, and also change your socks often. Like suppose you work out in the morning and you sweated a lot, you've done a brisk walk or a run or a workout, definitely if you're going to wear socks in the afternoon or evening, wear a fresh pair. Don't wear the same pair from morning, that sweaty pair, all through the day. And it's better to wear flip-flops when you go to the beach, on the sand, or if you're, going from when you change into your for your swim, you should wear flip-flops because otherwise you can pick up a water infection, So these are the ways in which you can look after your feet and prevent all these small nuisance value problems from cropping up.
We go later. Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about facial and a little bit of anti-aging for the hands, right? Because, anti-aging is face, neck, décolletage, that's just below the neck, and then comes the hands, right? You remember there was that one very famous photograph that came where they showed Madonna and she had this beautiful face and she was holding something and they said, your age is in your hands. Yeah, a long time ago. So when we keep looking at, we keep paying attention to all this, but we forget that this gives away our age. So there are a lot of treatments you can do which can correct photo damage, which can correct dehydration, or we can also do anti-aging treatments for the hands, which can help to make the skin look fresh and soft and hydrated and match your face and not give away your age, right? So we can do hand peels for the hands, we can do roller with skin boosters, we can inject skin boosters, we can do fillers for hands, we can do laser for the hands. So we can do a lot of these treatments nowadays to make the skin look smooth apart from products.
So
So
it's actually going to ask you what are what in because I'm not aware of what is happening new with these things. So I was going to ask you what are the treatments. So you enlisted quite a few, which I really feel like one should, because every time we are looking at face, but then hand is also something which people do notice. Don't forget that, and that's when these things do come in picture for sure.
yeah.
Awesome.
So yes, sir, do you need a solution for fungal infection? Yes, you do. Fungal infections have to be treated. They're very slow to grow, but if you neglect it, it can really destroy your nail. So it depends on the kind of fungal infection. If it's a simpler one, a lotion may do, but if it's a deeper one, then you may. So there are superficial and deep. So the deeper ones need a tablet as well. So you need to do a tablet and a lotion both.
Awesome.
If you have a fungal infection, also toenails, the fungal infection can be more stubborn because toenails grow very slowly and we tend to neglect our toenails. We look at the toenails last,
True, and they're more
in
prone
our.
to it. They're
Yeah,
more prone to
and they
infection.
are. They are, exactly.
So you must take care
So
of
if
them.
you. Another thing I've noticed with toenails, I've noticed that those who exercise, let me tell you a few situations. For example, marathon runners, they practice for about 6 months before the 21 or 42K. And about a month later, I've had marathon runners, normal people like you and me who want to run a marathon. And you want to do a good job of it. They come after 1 month, 6 weeks, and all their nails have fallen off. Or some of my patients have been sitting in Vajrasana, Vajrasana, no? They sit in Vajrasana and yoga for 5 minutes, 7 minutes, 10 minutes, and they put a lot of pressure on their feet and toes. So they start getting callosities on the, not on the soles, but on the
Awesome, the upper
top of
part.
the, they get those, or on the side, how you get those medial and lateral callosities. So that comes from sitting in Vajrasana for long, that pose for a long time and not maybe putting a cushion or a towel underneath. And also I've seen marathon runners coming 4 6 weeks later after the run with all their nails having fallen off because there's so much trauma. So trauma also affects the nails. And I've had a couple of people who have, they sleep like this. So they end up with blue nails. Their nails get hematomas or bruises. So their nails turn black and blue. So there are a lot of things we, funny habits we have. So personal habits, personal preferences can also affect the nails, the hands, and the feet. So, like you said, of course we got to treat it with the correct product. And there are lots of nice products. But we also need to find the cause. I want you to tell me what do you think of exfoliants like papaya or peppermint. Peppermint is more for soothing and
Relax.
stimulating circulation, relaxing. And papaya, I think papaya is a great exfoliant. Papain. So
Yeah.
papaya contains papain, and papain is an exfoliating enzyme. That's why a lot of masks and packs have papain, papaya extract, and that's why a lot of creams have it because they're exfoliating in nature.
Do smell good, and like people want to use papaya directly, but I really don't like the smell. But these creams, what we have, they are really good. They smell good as well as they are getting the benefits of the fruits and
Yeah,
stuff.
and actually, sometimes putting a good foot cream at night, suppose you're really, really tired, if you just massage a good foot cream, which is nice and nourishing, and with the pressure points, even if you don't know all the pressure points, but generally, you nicely massage your feet thoda sa and take away the fatigue from your feet at night, you just get so much better sleep, isn't it? So a
Arey,
little nice.
I believe in doing it. So if I don't have someone to do it for me, I do one thing. I don't know, it's a quick hack. I would just like to say, I put little bit on one side and the other side, rub my feet and get it nourished. And that also a bit of heat at the same time, it relaxes so that my work
I think
is
that's
done.
a, yeah, that's a great tip. Like you do this, right? You put it
Yeah.
on both feet and just massage them against each other.
Moha foot cream like that only. So every time you don't have some, I can do it myself also, and it does work, and it makes me feel so relaxed. Because standing for the whole day, it makes it really bad. So this thing works for me. Personal experience.
And it helps you to get absorbed also well, right?
Yeah, totally.
And tell me, which footwear do you prefer, platforms or stilettos or both?
as a
See,
blogger and a
I
dog
caught you on
walker,
this one. I
those are
caught you on
different.
this one.
So, like, I'm balancing my both the professions. I'm balancing in both the thing, like look wise as well as
Amazing.
purpose wise. So yeah,
Yeah.
sneakers and flip flops and all, they are good. When I have to stand a lot, especially sneakers, because they control the foot also well. They keep it protected, and when you're applying things and all that, they are inside because you're wearing socks and stuff. And of course, when you're going out, so suppose if I'm going for a dinner, all right, so I would wear it from, the car to the dinner, coming from the dinner to the car. And if I'm moving around, if I'm going to a mall, then I would change to sneakers immediately, because that makes more sense. Everything is in trend. If you carry it well, everything works for you. Just make sure what you're wearing, wear it correctly for your body as well. That's what I totally
Yeah,
believe it. Yeah.
absolutely. It's very, that's what the way your feet look can also indicate the kind of footwear you choose, and it can have a very negative effect on your hips, your knees,
Entire
you
gait
know
change.
that. Yeah, you know that because that's your work. That
Yeah.
it really affects your weight bearing, your pressure on the joints and your ligaments. So it's so important to, like you said, always carry an extra pair of shoes, a comfortable extra pair of shoes.
You're happy at night if you in stilettos the whole day, you will start ending up, something is hurting. Even if you don't have any alignment issues, then you will have that because of the pressure it takes. So this definitely work that works for me.
And in fact, I find a lot of the youngsters, like the teenagers especially, and those kids and kids, what kids love to wear Crocs and they never wash the Crocs. And teenagers wear the two putty flip flops, those thin flat ones. This is why we see maximum footwear, problems with children and teenagers because they like to wear that same pair all the time. And they don't give good weight bearing. So weight bearing footwear, heel pads, all these are very important.
Very important.
And and for the hands, I would say start taking care of your hands at a younger age. Don't
Yeah.
wait to see the signs. Just as you're doing it for your face, where you are going to start looking after your face skin even as early as 22, 23, you need to do the same thing for your hands. So it's so easy that whatever you're putting on your face or neck, you can also put it on your hands. Of course, you're not going to put strong things, but you can use retinol-based creams on your hands. You can use glycolic acid-based creams on your hands. You can use peptides. You can use aloe vera. You can use, these aloe vera peptide creams, natural and, other molecules mixed together. You can use even brighteners. on your creams on your hands, which have natural brighteners like arbutin and a little bit of glycolic acid, you can.
That's amazing. Like, I think bottom line is take care of your hands the same way like you try to take care of your face, because that also shows aesthetically. At the same time, it's very important for your health, because nails, you keep on eating, you do a lot of things with it, needs and feet for that matter. Yeah.
And also sunscreen. Never forget your sunscreen.
Yeah.
So the best is to use a lotion, even SPF 50 will do. Put two sprays here, two sprays here. You can even spray it on your feet, because hands and feet get tanned, isn't it?
So I am a person, I will cover everything, but then I don't wear gloves like how guys generally wear. So I have seen the tanning when I remove the ring, especially that part is only very whitish and the rest of it is tan. So that's when I realized that, this is too much of tanning. Now start putting sunscreen here as well, not just in
here. Even your feet can get tan. So you should put the sunscreen. So you can pick up a good body sunscreen with SPF 50, which has a combination of zinc oxide and, other good sunscreen agents, which can then, benzophenones and things like that. Or you can just pick up a sunscreen with titanium dioxide and zinc oxide, and you can just, it's a silicone base, so it's not sticky and you can stays long, and you can put it on your hands and put it on your feet, especially if you go for a beach holiday. And or if you're walking a lot in the sun, wearing open footwear, going for a holiday, like the whole world is going to Maldives and Goa, right?
Yeah.
So they can use a good sunscreen on their hands and feet, and when they get tanned and come back, they can exfoliate, nourish. So they can use a good scrub, exfoliating scrub. They can use a good nourishing oil-based cream, and then, but by using a sunscreen and a moisturizer every night, even on a holiday, you will not get photo damage. Photo damage ages the skin.
Oh, that's what?
Yeah. That's why then you'll have to put fillers or skin boosters or do rollers and apply, rejuvenating complexes and boosters. So now a lot of this is trending.
Nice, nice. That's good. Awesome. Super. So yes, so I think we have, I don't actually can't. You still need sunscreen so that you don't get tanned further, I would say.
Yeah, because if you're naturally tanned, your melanin is going to protect you. But it'll take a little longer than others, but you will end up with some photo damage anyway.
All right. I think we had a very fun session today. A lot of skincare tips, well, it's a lot of beauty tips this time, and I'm seriously going to try them all. And we have also mentioned about you should be addressing the causes of the problem, what we have discussed, like the detergent and other products what you're using. So a very, very beneficial session. Thank you so much for this. Facts, tips, very informative, as usual, Doctor.
Thank you, Sejal. Always lovely chatting with you, and you always seem to ask me all the right questions and get the right answers out of me. And as a final tip, I would say that don't forget your nuts, don't forget your seeds, don't forget a little bit of, if you can have some avocado, it's good for you, omega-3. You can also have a little bit of, pure virgin cold-pressed coconut oil, 1 teaspoon every night or in your diet, a little bit of homemade ghar ka ghee, a little bit goes a long way in giving that internal moisturization, which is also so important. Flax seeds, those are also good for sunflower, pumpkin seeds. So, at least 3 times a week, one of these things can go in, and they will complete. They give you the micronutrients for healthy skin, for your hands and feet, strengthen the skin as well as your nails, and keep you looking perfectly groomed and have that completely well-kept look. That would be my message.
That's awesome. So we have definitely nailed the topic. We've learned how to deal with it internally as externally. Yes, nailed it. So we are ending this session, Doctor. Thank you so much. And
thank you, Sejal.
thank you a lot. And tomorrow, you guys would be learning Ayurveda ways of dealing with the same problems with Dr. Manisha Mishra. And we're going to have a fun session at that time too. So stay tuned for tomorrow's live. And thank you again so much, Dr. Kohli. It was amazing talking to you.
Thank you. And thank you, Moha, SOS, the Save Our Skin campaign, for bringing us four times together. And I've enjoyed every one of these four. Catch you soon again. And thank you, viewers and followers. It was lovely being with all of you. Bye.
So much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye. See you soon.
See you soon. Yeah.